I'm delighted to introduce to you a young man who is ordained through one of our ministries, World Harvest Church Ministerial Fellowship. He is Pastor Jim DiPalma, the founder and senior pastor of World Overcomers Church in Carroll Stream, Illinois, just right outside of Chicago. I believe revival is coming to these great cities of our nation. We are not going to be intimidated anymore. We're going to get informed on the issues and recognize we've got to rebuild the foundations. Welcome, Pastor Jim DiPalma.
Pastor Parsley told me to go up there and swing the bat. We've come here to hit a home run for Jesus Christ of Nazareth. If you believe the glory of God is coming back to America, if you believe as the word of the Lord says, if my people, if you believe that revival and the glory of the Lord is coming back to America, lift your hands and give God the biggest shout of praise. Come on, give him a shout. Shout. Let the nations, let Washington hear you. Let America hear you. Let the nations hear you from the east, the west, the north, and the south. Give them a shout. The prophet of old said, I looked for an intercessor. We have a lot of travelers, but we need more travailers. The prophet of old said, I looked for an intercessor. But I found none. But thank God here in Washington, D.C. Thank God you who are watching across America and throughout the earth. I want you to know today in America, God has found an intercessor. God has found intercessors. And the Spirit of the Lord would say, it's time to sharpen the sword of intercession. It's time. Come on, put your hand out like this. And put your other hand like this. Come on, shout, it's time, America. It's time, church, to sharpen the sword of intercession. Now I want you to know today, Peter tells us in Acts chapter 3, verse 19, it says, repent therefore and be converted that your sins may be blotted out, so that the times of refreshing may come from the presence of the Lord. I submit to you today, God is restoring his presence back in his house. But in verse 20 and 21, it declares that Jesus Christ will not come back. The Bible says that all of heaven is withholding the return of the Lord until the season, the time and season of restoration of all things. Satan may have had us down, but we're not out. We're coming back. We're coming back. We're coming back. Come on, give God a shout. We're coming back. He prophesied and he promised the restoration, not of a couple things, but the restoration of all things. So today, as we line up as Joel's army, as we line up as Gideon's gang, as we line up as the remnant of God, eye has not seen, ear has not heard, nor has entered the heart of man what God's about to do. If you believe it, give him a praise. Grab a hand of the person next to you, all over this room today, all over this mall in Washington, D.C. Grab a hold of the hand. Where one still puts 1,000 to flight, and two still puts 10,000 to flight. Where if any two shall agree, it shall be done by our Father in heaven. Father, we come today. We thank you for the privilege to live in this hour, the day in which the prophets of old prophesied. Father, today I declare and I decree. Today, God, apostolically and prophetically, I declare and I decree that we will be the people without spot. We will be the people without blemish. We will be the people without wrinkle. And we say, even so, come, Lord Jesus. Give him the biggest shout.
Your anointing.
to.
I feel a trembling just under my feet. I feel a mighty giant just about to rise up out of obscurity and take its rightful place of leadership in America again.